Hi, everybody. Brad Nessler here with Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit, bringing you today's exciting matchup. It's a mild, clear day, so the weather won't be a factor in this battle between the Dartmouth Big Green and the Yale Bulldogs. And we're set to bring you another great matchup in the world of NCAA football. And here come the Bulldogs. I'll tell you, this one can go either way. Kirk, what do you think will happen today?
Yale has a guy at wide receiver that everybody's talking about, and for good reason. He's the strength of this offense, an offense that can really spread the ball around. Lee, watch for him to come up big in this one.
Forget about it. I'm calling the upset. Look out. I'm taking Dartmouth. And
this one's away. Number 35 takes it to 28. So now we'll get to see the offense come out of the field for their first drive of this game. They'll line up at the 35. It's first down. Yale comes out in the shotgun. On the ground with a tailback. Tackle made at the 35. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. From their own 35-yard line, it's second down and 10 to go. The Bulldogs line up with a single setback field. Gives it off. They'll get him for a loss. The defensive end came through to put him away.
Nice job of utilizing his athletic ability to get in there and then make a sure tackle.
Third down. Dartmouth has all their DBs in for this five-wide set. He's going right. This one is incomplete. Excellent series by this defense, forcing them to go three and out.
And the offense really struggled on this drive. They're going to have to pick it up if they want to move the ball on these guys.
The punter comes on the field, getting ready to send one off. Number 88 is back deep to return the punt. It's away, short punt. Number 88 fields it at the 50. Now we'll get to see how this quarterback can do today as he comes out of the field for the first time. They'll start this drive at midfield. Yale comes out in the 3-4. They're going to pitch it. Tackle at the 48-yard line. That run picks up a yard, maybe less. It's second and 9. Ball right around midfield. They use four linebackers. They'll bring him down at the 38. And that was an excellent run there.
Yeah, Brad, but it was also great blocking up front by the offensive line to open up the hole.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 38. Yale going with a three-man front. Again, he'll get the call. And they'll bring him down behind the line. Loss of one there for the halfback. It's second down and 11 to go.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
Number 7 with three wide receivers. Nice play fake. He lets it go. And this one falls incomplete. Number 88 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it third down.
Right.
Third and 11. Ball on the 39. Dartmouth goes with the ace set here. Back to pass. Number 7 passes. That's incomplete. Dartmouth lining up the punt. Number 25 is back awaiting the punt. Didn't get all of that one. Number 1 signals for a fair catch. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They'll get the ball here at the 20. The Bulldogs come out in the ace formation. They'll get him for a loss. The halfback just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of 1. They line up at the 19. Second and 11. The Bulldogs go with the I formation. Tosses it out. They'll grab 10 yards there.
Gain of 10 on the play.
They line up at the 29. Third down, a yard to go. They'll try to get the first on the ground. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. A great defensive effort there.
And let me tell you, the key to that play was right there in the defensive line. They tied this offensive line up and allowed their linebackers to come up and make a big play.
Lee, I agree with you. We always talk about the linebackers and safeties, but credit the big guys up front for that play.
They come out in a punt formation. Number 88 is the deep man awaiting the return. It's away, short punt. Number 88 picks up the loose ball. They nearly gave that ball away.
But luckily that guy was paying attention to what was going on and was able to recover the football.
They'll take over at the 44-yard line. Dartmouth sets up in the eye, tosses it out. Brought down at the 40-yard line. 4 yards there on the toss. Second and 6.
Ball on the 40-yard line.
Number 2 is the deep pass as they line up in the eye. They go with the run. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. The defensive end was the victor on that play as he bolted in to tackle him for a loss.
And he was able to do that because the interior linemen held their ground, leaving the runner with no options.
It's 3rd and 7. Ball on the 41. They go with the toss. Tackled at the 31. What a run on third down.
You know, we're always talking about the importance of converting on third down. If you're going to have any kind of success, you got to be able to keep these drives alive, like they did right there.
First down, 10 to go. The Bulldogs come out in the 34 defense. Tackle made at the 29. Number 2 gains about 2 yards on the run. From the 29-yard line, second down. The big green come out in the ace formation. Setting up play action. Looks. He lets it fly. Number 88 hauls it in for the touchdown. What a strike for the score.
And he did a nice job of looking off his defender.
They line up for the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So down to just a few seconds left in the first quarter with a score, Dartmouth 7, Yale nothing. Dartmouth is lining up to kick this one off. Number 88 and number 4 back to return. Short kickoff. Number 4 fields it at the 27. Well, the offense couldn't get anything going on their last drive. Let's see if they can do a little bit better here. They'll go to work at the 41-yard line. The Bulldogs come out in a shotgun. Looking to pass. He's looking for his man. He snags it. He's taken down at the 47-yard line. A long ways yet to go, but at the end of one, our score, Dartmouth 7, Yale nothing. They line up at the 47. Second and 4. Yale lines up with 3 receivers. Throws this one out to the left. They can't connect. Incomplete. Number 88 was the intended target, so that'll make it third down. Third down.
Ball on the 47-yard line.
The Bulldogs line up with a single set backfield. Play action. Looking. Rolls to the right. Number 11 passes. And that one's fallen incomplete. Number 28 was the intended target on the play. That's going to bring up fourth down. Yale lining up the punt. Number 41 is waiting for the snap. Number 41 punts it and he didn't get much distance on it. Number 88 fields it at the 39. Thanks to some nice passing on the last drive, the offense was able to take it down the field for 6.
And great play calling to help make that an easy drive. The question is, can they do it again?
We've got a 1st and 10. Ball on their own 38.
1st and 10.
Yale lines up defensively in a 3-4. Hands it to the back. He sheds it. Brought down at the 48-yard line. 10-yard pickup on the play. Second down and short. Ball on the 48-yard line from the gun. And they make the stop at the 49.
On the run, 3-yard gain on the play.
First down. Three-man front defensively. Back to pass. Slings it. It falls incomplete. Number 88 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up 2nd down. It's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 49. Defense lines up to 3-4. Drops back to pass. Number 7 unloads. Number 86 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll make it 3rd down. Third down and 10 coming up. Ball on the 49-yard line. Drops back to pass. Steps up across the middle. He's right there for the interception. And credit the safety with that last interception.
He knew exactly where the quarterback was going with the football. It's not always about athletic ability. You've got to be a smart player and know what's going on out there.
And that comes from breaking down film of the opposing offense and paying attention all week in practice. This safety was ready for today's game.
The offense will start at the 32-yard line.
First and 10.
Number 28 is the single setback. Hands it to the back. Gets past the tackler. Fumble. Loose ball. Recovered by the offense. The offense is lucky to retain possession after that fumble.
The coach can't be happy with the way the running back is carrying the football.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 49. Number 11 comes to the line with three wide. He passes it, and they couldn't hook up on that one. And he led his receiver a little too much.
One of the things you look for when you have a young quarterback is how he releases the football. Here you can see he releases the ball a little bit early, a sign that he wasn't completely comfortable with what he was seeing.
Second down. Yale comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Gives to the tailback. Number 28 gets 3 yards on the play.
3 yard gain on the play.
Third down, 7 yards to go. Ball right around midfield. Yale lines up in a bunch formation. Moves up in the pocket. Throws it out there. He's taken down at the 43-yard line. Doesn't get enough for the first down.
Yeah, nice job of making a few yards, but they got to be disappointed they didn't make the first down.
They line up to punt this one away. Number 17 is back to receive. Number 41 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Number 21 calls for the fair catch. Their last drive ended when they decided to try for it on fourth down and were turned away by the defense. They'll set up shop at the 27.
Start the drive at the 27-yard line. First and 10.
Dartmouth lines up with three receivers. Setting up the play action. He's looking. Rolling out to the right side. He decides to run with it.
Number 7 with the carry. 1 yard gain on the play.
From their own 28-yard line. Second down and 9 to go. They come out with three wide receivers. They'll get him for a loss. Yale will take a timeout, and that was their first timeout. They'll line up at the 25. We've got third and 12. Yale comes out defensively with six defensive backs. Look at the throw. Number 7 throws. This one is incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down.
Fourth down, and let me say one thing. This defense was up to the task that time in shutting down the pass play.
Yeah, they shut it down, and they got the three and out they were looking for.
The big green are lining up to punt it away. Number 88 will be the return man. Number 93 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Number 88 fields it to the 42. Nowhere to go there.
Nowhere is right. He's lucky he got any yards on that return.
Great job of getting downfield and making the tackle by the coverage team.
Yale trying to put a drive together here to tie it up before halftime. Yale comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. The halfback with a carry. They'll bring him down at the 30. That was a pretty good run.
Incredible effort there, running the football by this guy.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30. Dartmouth has all their DBs in for this 5-1 set. And he's taken down at the 27. It's second down and 7 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. He'll get the call again. He jukes it. And he's tackled at the 19-yard line. The Bulldogs are going to take a timeout, and they'll have one timeout left. First down, 10 to go. We'll see what they can do in the red zone. They're in the eye. They'll go with a run once again. Tackle at the 18-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
1 yard gain on the play.
Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 18. Dartmouth brings in their nickel package, steps up in the pocket, flips it, caught, and he's tackled in the open field. And they're building some great momentum on this drive, guys.
That's right, Brad. That was a crisp pass by the quarterback, and they're looking pretty good moving the ball right now.
Number 28 is a deep back as they line up in the eye. Let's it fly. Touchdown, Bulldogs. So it's the running back who shows off his hands on the touchdown.
It's such a bonus to have a back who can contribute to the passing game.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. Down to just a few seconds left here before the half. And our score, Yale 7, Dartmouth 7. Number 43 is lined up to kick this one off.
Number 88 back deep.
And this one's away. Number 88 fields it at the 26. The 50. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. He returns it all the way to score. How about that return?
Great effort there by the returner, reading his blockers and evading the tacklers. And the results? 6 points.
They'll line up for the extra point here. He makes the PAT. Down to just a few seconds left here before the half. And our score, Dartmouth 14, Yale 7. Number 27, get set to kick this one away. Short kickoff. Number 88 takes it to 25. The offense comes out on the field once again.
It'll be interesting to see if this defense has made any adjustments to stop this running game.
Because they sure couldn't stop them from going down the field and scoring on that last drive.
The offense will take over at the 38-yard line.
First and 10.
Number 28 is the single setback. Throws a bullet, and that one's incomplete. The receiver didn't have a chance on that one. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Dartmouth lines up in a dime defense here. Back to pass. Steps up. He's hit and got away. Sack for a loss. At the 31.
Seven yards.
And that'll do it for the first half of play. Our halftime score, Dartmouth 14, Yale 7. Yale is lining up to get this second half started. And it's a short kickoff. Number 88 takes it to 25. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. Looking to pass. They bring him down. We've got a second and long. Ball on their own 32. Number 7 with 3 wide receivers. Looks. Throws. They can't connect. Incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
From their own 32-yard line, third down. The big green line up in an I formation, drops back to pass, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. The tackle got embarrassed that time, allowing the end to come free for the sack.
That's what you call a lookout block. The tackle gets beat and yells, "Look out!" Trust me, it's not what you want to hear as a quarterback.
Here comes the punter looking to boot this one away. Number 88 is back deep to return the punt. Number 93 punts it, and he didn't kick that ball well at all. Number 88 fields it for 44.
He couldn't shake anybody. He needs to go work out those legs a little bit.
Yeah, Coach, you're right. Pretty good return. But if he could have broken that last tackle, that might have been big.
We'll see if they can capitalize on the good field position. They hand it off. Gets past the tackler. Tackle made at the 28-yard line, and they pick up 9 there. It's second down and 1 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Here's the halfback. Spin move, and they got him for a loss. They get a 1-yard loss on that one. 1-yard loss on the play. Third down and 2. Ball on the 29-yard line. The Bulldogs come to the line with their jumbo package. Throws it, and this one falls incomplete. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. They'll keep it on the ground again. And down he goes at the 29. And that was a big stop defensively.
Yeah, they only needed a few yards here to keep the drive alive. Great job by the defense to shut them down.
They'll start this drive at the 29-yard line. First and 10. Dartmouth comes to the line with 3 wide. With a misdirection, brought down at the 33-yard line. A pickup of 4 on the play. From their own 33-yard line, 2nd and 6. Defense lines up at a 3-4.
He'll get it again.
And he's tackled at the 40-yard line. Picked up a first down on that carry.
Yeah, a good job up front by the offensive line. They picked up some nice blocks to allow that back to get in there for some extra yardage.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. Yale comes out in a 3-4. Setting up the play action. Throws this one out to the right. Got him on the run. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 32-yard line. He found his halfback and turned it into a big game.
This kid is a very versatile back. He can run the ball. He can make the catch. But what you don't notice is his blocking. This guy's just an all-around player.
First and 10.
Ball on the 32-yard line.
The big green set up in the gun. Tackle made at the 29-yard line.
On the carry, 3-yard gain on the play.
It's second down.
Ball on the 29-yard line.
Dartmouth lines up with three receivers. Back to pass. Slips it short. That's incomplete. Overthrown, intended for the wideout. From the 29-yard line. It's third down and 7 yards to go. They're going to pitch it. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. Number two gains about a yard on the play. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. The defense lines up in a dime. He throws, and they couldn't hook up on that one. And that stop really gives these guys a swing of momentum, fellas.
You bet, Brad. That defensive play really ignited a fire on the sideline.
Yeah, this is a great chance for the offense now to build off that momentum and put some crucial points on the board.
They'll take over at the 28. He flings it. Complete. He ignores the footsteps and makes the catch. How about that pass, fellas?
Well, Brad, the defense was coming with a blitz, and that opened some room for these guys to get open.
Yeah, and if you're coming with the blitz, you better get to this quarterback. Otherwise, he'll make you pay.
From their own 49-yard line, first down. First down. Look at the throw. This one is incomplete. He sailed that one high.
That's not a bad incompletion because he saw the blitz coming and just got rid of the ball to avoid losing yardage.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 49. He's looking to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Shakes off a tackle. And he's going to be sacked. It's third down.
Ball on the 43-yard
line. Yale comes out with five receivers. Lets it fly. And he's got him on the run. He's taken down at the 40.
Good job of attacking the coverage to keep the drive alive.
That was a great-looking pass to move the sticks on third down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. The Bulldogs come out with split backs. Play action. He passes it. Finds his receiver. And down he goes at the 30. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Well, only a quarter remains, and we've got a tight game with the score. Dartmouth 14, Yale 7. Second down and less than a yard. Ball on the 30-yard line. Feeds it to the back. He tries to spin. And he's tackled at the 17. They pick up another first, guys.
Great job here converting and keeping this defense on the field. They're getting very tired.
First down, 10 yards to go. They're threatening inside the 20. Their last trip down here was a success. Let's see if this one will result in another touchdown. He picks up 4 yards on the carry. It's second and six. Ball on the 13-yard line. Inside handoff. Tackle made at the 2-yard line. What a run.
Here they give it to the tailback and a little misdirection play. And you can see the athleticism and the ability to make guys miss. Nice play.
So here we go. First and goal, and a field goal won't cut it. It's power football time, folks. Again, he'll get the call. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. And the blitz might have caused that one.
Now the defense took a chance here. They overloaded that side of the ball, and the tailback had nowhere to go.
Second down and goal. Yale goes with the ace set here. Setting up play action. To the end zone! Number 88 was the intended target on the play. That'll make it third down. This is from the 5-yard line. It's third and goal. The Bulldogs line up with three wide. Number 11 unloads. He put just a little too much power behind that throw to his receiver.
Oh, boy, guys. I think he'd like that pass back.
Yeah, Kirk, he won't miss that receiver too often.
It's fourth and goal from the 5. Let's see if the defense can make a stand here. Looks to pass. He throws right, and he's got the touchdown. A nice play as the offense gets it through the air.
Yeah, they've had some success in their short passing game, so they felt confident they could make that play work down inside the 10.
The extra point to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. So with less than 4 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter, our score, Yale 14, Dartmouth 14. Number 88 is back ready to receive, and boy, has he been the game breaker on special teams today. And this one's a short kick. Number 9 takes it to 25. I don't think we'll see this offense get into a similar situation this time.
So you think they'll convert on fourth down if they go for it again?
Hey, why not? If you're having to go for it on fourth down a lot, you're not doing so hot, sweetheart.
So they'll start this drive at midfield. Dartmouth sets up in the eye. They're going to pitch it. Good open field tackle.
And the offensive line did a good job of picking up the blitz.
Yep, the defense over pursued the play, and it helped them get some good yards.
Second and inches. Ball on the 43. The big green come out showing three wide. The halfback with a carry. There's a fumble. Defense says they've got it, and they do. What a huge time to lose the football.
Yeah, you can't cough it up late in a tie ball game like this. If they end up losing because of that fumble,
This poor guy is going to be looked at as the GOAT.
They'll go to work at the 39-yard line. One man backfield. On the ground with the tailback. And he's stopped behind the line.
This is a heads-up play by the linebacker. He's playing run and had his eyes on the guy carrying the football from the get-go. Good defensive play.
Second down. Again with the run. And they make the stop at the 43-yard line. Number 28 comes away with 5 yards on the carry. Third down. Number 11 comes to the line with three wide. Number 11 lets it fly. Has it to the senior. And he's tackled at the 38-yard line. Good pickup by the receiver.
Yeah, this kid loves to play. He wants the ball every time they throw it up.
First and 10. Ball on the 38. Number 28 lines up in the deep back. Eye formation. Here's the halfback. And he's tackled in the open field. Number 28 gains about a yard on the play. Second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 37-yard line. Yale comes out with an eye formation. Inside give. And he's taken down at the 36. Number 28 picks up a yard on the play. This defense faces another third down. Ace backfield. He drops back. He steps up. He looks. He throws it. Incomplete pass. He overthrew his tight end.
I know the tight end has a little more height than the wideouts, but give me a break.
Congratulations to our players of the game. These guys were playing on a very high level today. The defense sets up in the dime. They need this pass. Throws this one out to the left. They couldn't convert that fourth down.
Boy, look at these guys out there. They are fired up. Now let's see if it's going to lead to any points.
They'll set up shot at the 36-yard line. Number 7 with three wide receivers. Drops back to pass. Throwing right. They can't connect. Incomplete. Number 9 was the intended receiver on that pass. That'll bring up second down. They line up at the 36. Second and 10. The Bulldogs line up in a 3-4. Looks to pass. Across the middle. Incomplete. Number 88 was the intended target on the play. That'll make it third down. From their own 36-yard line, we've got third and 10. Looking to throw. He lets it go. Incomplete pass.
Not a lot of success for this offense on this drive, Coach.
The defense did exactly what they had to do, and that stopped them for three and out.
So they're set to punt this one away. Number 88 is back deep to return. Number 93 punts it, and he didn't get much distance on it. Number 88 takes it to 47. A confident defense heads out of the field after stopping this offense on a fourth down attempt the last time they were on the field.
The last thing you want to do is to come out and do nothing again and give them even more confidence.
We're down to just a minute in this game. Number 28 lines up as a single back. Fakes to the back. Down the middle. And it's incomplete.
He almost had him there, Coach.
Yeah, well, guess what? It doesn't count if you almost threw a good pass. Almost doesn't count.
Sounds like a head coach talking.
Yeah.
It's second and ten. Ball on the 49-yard line. Back to pass. Moves up in the pocket. He throws it. Incomplete pass.
Not a pretty pass right there.
No, it wasn't, Kirk. That was not a good pass at all. But hey, in his defense, he had to get it off to avoid the sack.
Third down.
Ball on the 49-yard line.
The big green bringing the nickel package. He drops back. He's looking for his man, and it falls incomplete. That brings up a punting situation.
I'll tell you what, this defense did a heck of a job that time to hold them to three and out.
Yale ready to put this one away. Number 41 awaits the snap. It's a short kick. And he can't hang on to the ball. Well, there's not that much time left, and we've still got a tie ball game.
The good teams win games like this, Brad. And at this point, it's just a matter of which team wants it most.
And this should be a great finish, guys.
It's first and 10, ball on the 34. Gives it off. Tackle made at the 28-yard line. The Bulldogs call a timeout, and they've got two remaining. Second and four. Ball on the 28. The Bulldogs are going to take a timeout, and now they've only got one remaining. From the 28-yard line. Third down. Number 11 comes to the line with three wide. Throws it. And he's got him on the run. He was just inbound when he made the catch.
Nice throw here by the quarterback to the sideline. He placed it perfectly where only his guy could make the catch.
First and 10. They're inside the 20. Their last trip down here was a success. Let's see if this one will result in another touchdown. Drop back a yard.
On the tackle, 1 yard loss on the play.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. The Bulldog line up in a split back set. Again, he'll get the call. Oh, he got tattooed on that one. And he goes over the century mark with that run, guys.
You know, Brad, he's had a great day, but credit the offensive line for fine blocking all game long.
Yale will call a timeout. Folks, we're either going to see victory with this field goal or overtime. Here we go. The kick is up, and it's good. And that gives them the lead.
I know that I call kickers head cases, but this kid isn't one. It's like he doesn't even feel the pressure.
Well, he better stop celebrating. There's still time on the clock, and he has to kick the ball off.
This might be the final play of the game. They need to return this kick all the way, or this one's over. And it's a short kickoff. Number 82 fields at the 29. There's the final gun, and this game is history. Kirk, any final thoughts here?
I'm sad to see this one end because it was a great game to watch. Dartmouth played a good game out there, but they needed to make one or two more big plays, and they couldn't do it. Who knows? Another couple of minutes, and this one may have gone the other way.
Folks, thanks for tuning into our game. Our final score, Yale 17, Dartmouth 14. This is Brad Nessler with Lee Corso and Kirk Herbstreit saying thanks and so long.